Hello everyone, Michael here with the Daily Note 2 and 3. Welcome to another tips and tricks video. Today I want to show you an app called Photo Reader and what makes this app so special. This app extends the feature of Samsung Keyboard and the Gallery app in a really interesting way. It may also prove to be a crucial tool to have in your pocket when you're traveling to a foreign country, so let's have a look at what this app can do. So here's the app called Photo Reader. It's an app that will turn your text on paper into characters for input, but that's not what makes this app special. It's special in a way it expands features of some of your Samsung apps on your Galaxy Note 2. I'm going to install it on the Note 2. Unfortunately, at this time, it doesn't work on the Note 3, although I do see signs that they are still working on it. More on that in a little bit. So after you install it, let's open the Gallery app. And say you took a picture of a document or have a screenshot of some text. When you hit menu, you will see a new option there called Detect Text. Make sure you have the right language selected and there you go. You can make edits as necessary. You can even share it to Google Translate and get a translation of that. Another thing this app does is it extends the functions of your Samsung keyboard. Say you wanted to paste text of something you were looking at onto something like S Note. You can do it by long tapping on this button next to the space button. And you will now see the camera with the T on there. Select that and it will activate the camera. You can scan anything with text, snap the image, hit the check button, and now the text is on your S Note. One last thing, this app can be used as a standalone app and it does entirely different things. A practical feature you might find useful is its dictionary mode, which offers a live foreign dictionary. If you ever tried filling out a form in a foreign country, this might be a lifesaver. You have to make sure you have downloaded the right dictionary for this to work though. In a mode called Direct Link, it will recognize phone numbers, email addresses, and web addresses to create links for you to make phone calls, send emails, or check out that website. I think this feature would be nice if it worked quicker and more reliably when, for example, grabbing a link from your computer monitor. It seems to struggle with this especially because of how camera sensor bands subpixels together. It certainly helps when you get a little further away. Also, it seems to cut off the link when there is a question mark in the link, which is unfortunate because most links today do contain question marks. A couple of tips, since getting a clear image is key, you need to make sure of a few things. Make sure the picture you're taking is shot with good lighting. Make sure it's in focus and the lens isn't smudged. And make sure the text is upright to the orientation of the app. As mentioned, it doesn't seem to work on the Note 3. I sideloaded the latest version of the app because I couldn't install it through the Google Play Store. It used to crash, but now it says my device doesn't have enough free space, which is not true. I can access it through the Gallery app, but cannot access the other functions shown in this video. So that's Photo Reader, a powerful app that comes with unique ways to extend functionality of your Samsung apps and then some. I don't know of any other apps that extend the functionality of Samsung apps in such clever ways, but if you do find one or know of one, make sure you share that info in the comments below. Also, I hope that Samsung updates this app to make it work on the Note 3 because it really is a great tool to have in your pocket for those who need it.
So that's it for today's video. More tips to come for the Samsung Galaxy Note 2 and 3. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure to hit that like button and subscribe for more upcoming videos. And as always, thanks for watching.